Say it's great. Maybe it's only almost good. But that's as good as it's gonna get, as far as I'm concerned. What do we got here? So actually, let me tell you a story here. Let's do this in story format. First try was the EFL-1B, right? Basically, I just, you know, I tried to treat these instruments like basically a flugelhorn. You know, take a flugelhorn mouthpiece, a big flugelhorn mouthpiece, and say, 4.2 millimeter throat, that sounds fine. Try that. Too big. How did that happen? You know, I didn't realize it. Didn't realize that at the time anyways, but I did basically prove that none of the mellophone or marching French horn instruments are anything related to the flugelhorn, because I don't know what flugelhorn the EFL-1B is made for, but I bet it doesn't, like, do a 60-cent nosedive an eighth partial. Now, this. Went back to the drawing board, got some advice. Maximilian Clear always giving me great advice. Brilliant, brilliant guy. This is an EFL-1C, so it's about probably 17 millimeter-ish, I didn't ask. Deeper than the Joseph Clear C-Cup flugelhorn mouthpiece, way deeper than any of the cornet mouthpieces, massive compared to the 6M, and really shallow compared to any alto horn mouthpiece. Again, the answer is always somewhere in the middle that you aren't allowed to buy. Now, the secret sauce, the throat size. And when you increase throat size, what you are doing is you are conceding to the instrument, I am giving you a bigger cup. That's basically what you're doing. If it plays flat when you play up high, you increase throat size, and the instrument is suddenly happy with how much cup volume it has, right? That's probably what makes the 6.5 AL work so often. Now, if players are actually getting away with that on the alto trombone, I'm not sure, but that's for another day. So what throat size have I got here? 4.8. Now, maybe that doesn't sound that big to you if you're familiar with French horn mouthpieces. I assure you, that's pretty big for 17 millimeter cup. That's massive for the cup sizes like this, actually. I think Joseph Clear's Alto Horn A cup, which it has a 4.8 millimeter throat, I think that's going to be like somewhere around 22 to 24 millimeter deep. Not sure exactly, but even if it's 22, that's a lot deeper than this. These instruments are tiny. They're not even anywhere close to your average alto sax horn. And the alto sax horn is already a thing that hates cup volume. So, ooh. So yeah, that's what I got wrong. I was on the right path, but I underestimated how small the marching French horn variety of instruments really are. They are tiny. You have to treat them as such. Way less cup volume. And, you know, a big throat. Now, how much further can I go with this design? Because if I make the cup deeper, the back bore would technically be shallower. And I suppose if you calculated it right, maybe you could just keep this back bore design and just let it get bigger naturally. I'm not going to test that. I'm not going to do it because I'm just not confident that I would get anything out of it. I can tell you this. So this back bore is probably ranging from somewhere where the text is all the way to the end. And this is already longer than a regular French horn mouthpiece. That is a long back bore. Super, super lucky that I got a back bore that was so good that would work with this setup. I don't know that there's that much further I could take this. I don't think I'd get anything out of it. Just lose range, basically. I sound a little bit better. But this sounds pretty decent, so I think it's fair to say that this is no worse than a medium deep cup for these instruments. Like the EFL 1B, that cup depth, that's probably, if that's not as deep as you can go, it's close. Any dreams that you might have of trying to put something closer to a French horn mouthpiece cup on these things, like, oh, you say, well, you just do 24 millimeter deep and 5.6 millimeter throat. That ain't gonna happen. You're not gonna get a backbore that'll work for that. If you've ever looked down like a Schilke 32, there basically is no backbore in that mouthpiece. You can see the end of the shank through the throat. That's not gonna work here. And that's the limiting issue with my plan here. I wanted a Mellophone mouthpiece design that would play in tune, 8 partials, and work on all these shank types. And, well, the French horn shank, I'm pushing it to its limits. I don't think I can get anything more out of it than this. And, okay. One instrument I don't think I'm ever going to be able to fix, and I'm very sad to say this, the Getzen Frumpet. I tried this mouthpiece on the Getzen Frumpet, 40 cents flat at 8th partial. People who have played the Getzen Frumpet would probably steal a kidney to get 40 cents flat at 8th partial, but the nerds that would say that's horrifying, they're right. That's not good enough to say I did it. I really wanted to be able to say I fixed the Getzen Frumpet without modifying it. At this point, I'm tempted to ream the receiver and try and tune it that way. But, close. Just like this. I mean, this, the King Altonium, not a good instrument. But this is close, okay? Maybe close but no cigar? Close. And I'll take close compared to not close at all. Because, you know what, historically, using a like Farkas MDC on this thing, people did that. If people did that, then this, with its super sharp second and fourth partial, this is a massive success, okay? I win. And you also clear did it first. Don't forget it.